The 2x2 is probably the most played and simplest base in Rust. It is cheap, reliable, and easily expendable. So I decided to make my own version. We got a spacious mini China wall, two of the twin bunkers for the perfect offline protection, and tons of angles for online raid defenses. The starter base is easy to build and already secure for low build costs. The bunkers are easy and fast to build, but expensive to raid. The base has the opportunity to be built in quick small steps, perfect for snowballing. I'd be so happy if you like my designs and keep subscribing to my channel. If you want to stay updated or need help with anything, you can join my Discord. Link is in the description. Now let's get into the base tour. We got 4 external TCs in total, which I built disconnectable. You just place this foundation right here, a roof on top, and the frames were disconnected. If you want to connect the TC again, just replace these frames. Going inside the compound, we got some retake peaks on the left and right. I separated the compound by these chain links, but it's optional, you don't need to build it exactly like I did. Inside the compound, we got lots of turret angles. And we got simple quick respawns on the separating foundations with peaks. But we got some proper bedrooms also, with even more peaks to retake the compound. We enter the mini China wall through this airlock. It is covered from different turret angles as well, which makes it really hard to breach. We also got bedrooms in here. And there are some nice extra peaks into the compound. The entrance is on second floor. We got some sneaky hidden loot behind these vending machines in a locker. You can only access the locker through the small gap. There are two basic loot rooms and space for batteries, furnaces and a workbench. Also the hidden loot on the upper side. To open the offset bunker, we place a roof like that. Destroy it again. And the triangle floor is gone. Now we can enter the main core 2x2. There is enough space for loot, a workbench, furnaces and bags. Now we open the other bunker. It works in exactly the same way. The floor is gone and we can access the loot room. It got space for 4 large boxes and a small one. So you can separate your loot and force the raiders to go through HQ 2 times, since the bunkers are not splashable. You can place beds and lockers on the jump ups and on third floor. Up here we got some more loot and battery space. Jumping up here we got the shooting floor and nice wide angles from that ramp. The gaps give you perfect angles in all directions. Jumping down here in the peak, we can aim on people close inside the compound or China wall. Up here we got the roof peaks to retake your roof in top-down raids. There is space for beds and boxes for quick respawns and a defense. Here is a little bed area which you can build if you play with more than a trio and need more beds. If you don't need it, you can just use it for industrial stuff or more box space. On the roof we got even more nasty angles. From here you can shoot people further away. And we got multiple of these peaks, so you can shoot in every direction. Here we got this little mountain roof. You're a bit higher up and don't need to expose too much of your body. Now it's time to start with the tutorial. So we start building the starter base. It's just a simple 2x2 with an airlock. Now we build the jump ups on both sides. Next step is building the offset bunker. We build a triangle and a square. Now we build 9 triangles on the left and end it with a square on the right. And now you delete everything but the last square. Now you go back with squares and build a low wall. You build a triangle through the low wall. Then you upgrade the triangle. Now we build a square again and build 9 triangles on the left and end with a square. Delete everything but the last square. Go back with squares and build 2 half walls. The triangle has to be connected to the half walls. And the triangle frame has to be attached to the wall. If the triangle has 10% stability, the bunker works. Make sure you can actually open the bunker. Now you build exactly the same on the other side. Next step is building the honeycomb. Upgrade these middle walls to metal. Now we have to build the hidden locker, otherwise you can't build them later. The next step is building the external TCs. That's the bedroom, that's why we don't need a door here. You build a high foundation here and a half wall on top. High foundation is very important. Now we build the externals for the mini China wall. Go out 4 squares and go back with triangles. Next step is building the Shiner Wall footprint. Now we build the Shiner Wall. Next step is building the third layer. Build this roof here. Now we build the frames for the shooting floor. have to place these boxes now because you can't place them later. Next step is building the compound. Now we finished the roof. Now we have to place the barricades. And now I'll show you the turret, battery, and windmill placement.